When you open a new blank workbook, cells are set to a default size. However, as seen here, you may want to go beyond the default size depending on the type of spreadsheet you're working on. This column has been resized, for example, but not quite enough. A couple addresses are still getting cut off. I'm just going to increase the column width a little by positioning my mouse over the line in the column heading, then clicking and dragging it to the right. You can get even more precise results with the format command. Choose column width to change the column to a specific measurement. The width is measured in pixels. Another option is to auto-fit the column, which will automatically adjust the column so it fits the contents of the cells exactly. Just go to Format, Auto-fit Column Width. Now the column is perfectly sized to the text. Rows work the same way. You can click and drag the line to adjust the height manually, or use the Format command to auto-fit or specify the height. Now I need to add another name to this contact list. I'd like to put it in between rows 3 and 4. To insert a new row, all you have to do is select the row below where you want the new one to appear. Now click the Insert command. Your row appears along with the Insert Options button, which lets you choose the formatting for your new cells. I'm going to keep the default, which is the same formatting as the row above. The process is similar for inserting a new column. Just select the column to the right of where you want the new one to go. Click the Insert command, and the new column will appear to the left. Always make sure you select the entire row or column by clicking the heading when you're getting ready to insert a new one. Otherwise, you'll only insert a cell. This is also a good rule to remember for deleting columns and rows. You'll want to make your entire selection, then click the Delete command. Now let's take a look at wrapping text, which is one way of addressing cells that contain more text than they can actually display. For example, I'd like to resize my column of addresses to about half its current size, but still be able to see the contents. The Wrap Text command can help by displaying the text on multiple lines. Just click, and the text and the rows adjust automatically. Now for the finishing touch, combining the cells in the top row of my spreadsheet so the title can be centered in a single large cell. To do this, select the cells you want to merge together, then click the Merge and Center command. There, that's perfect. To access more merge options, open the drop-down menu here. You can merge your cells across, creating merged rows instead of a single large cell if you have multiple cells selected. You can also merge without centering, or split your cells up again. The best way to learn about merging cells, wrapping text, and inserting and deleting columns and rows is to practice. So give it a try with your own Excel spreadsheet and have fun!
Like what you just saw? Rate it.
Add a comment.
Subscribe to our channel.
The freedom to learn.
What you want? When you want.
Absolutely free.
GCFLearnFree.org.